everyone. I'm Mandrea Donsky, host of New Hope Network's Soapbox Series. And today I'm here with David Knoll, founder of Pacific Resources International, an import and distribution company for exclusive New Zealand products. Welcome to the show, David.
Thanks, Andrea. It's good to see you today.
It's good to see you too. I absolutely loved reading your bio, and I was wondering if you could share a little bit about your journey and why you started Pacific Resources International.
Well, it's a long story, and I don't know if we have enough time to tape it all, but it started out by a mistake, like most things that happened in my life. I came over here with three grandchildren to visit my mom and dad after being in New Zealand for about 7 or 8 years. And it was kind of a surprise visit for them. Some friends in New Zealand that I'd helped with beekeeping for a couple of months decided that they needed to stuff some jars of honey into my suitcases and make big sales in the U.S. I didn't know that I would be so effective in that, because coming from America, living in New Zealand for 13 years, I had an interface that I could use that I was unaware of. So when I got here and I started showing the New Zealand honeys around, of course, it was a no-brainer for the people in Santa Barbara. They had the disposable income to pay the extra high prices of New Zealand honey, and the quality just spoke for itself. And so it was just a downhill run from there. I got one store, I got two stores, and then we attended the first Anaheim convention with about 20 people in those days. And then it just kept mushrooming from there. I got a big blue van, loaded it up every month, went around from San Francisco to San Diego and unloaded it. And I didn't come back. My wife said, don't come back unless you're empty.
I love hearing about the simplicity and how it was 20 people. My gosh. I know I'm joking, but like, wow, that's compared to today. It's amazing how much it's grown the industry. So it's really
cool. Yeah, those relationships have lasted, you know, the last 30 years, you know, and of course the industry is mushroomed, and we've all found ourselves in different places, but we've always kind of stuck together and helped each other along the road. It's been great.
I love that. Now, I love honey, and New Zealand is very well known for Manuka honey. What is real Manuka honey?
Oh, that's a good question. And it's it can be a little bit complex to answer. Real Manuka honey has certain aspects to it, actually four markers that make it real Manuka honey. That's the new regulations from MPI, that's the Ministry of Primary Industries in New Zealand. They came out finally about 2 years ago, about 2018, and decided to clean up the act. We had a lot of problems prior to that. It started in England, probably in 2016. With more Manuka honey being sold in England than there was being produced in New Zealand. And so they brought in some pretty strict regulations and closed down a few companies that were not following the rules or selling stuff overseas that they shouldn't have been selling, and started to clean it up. So there's four markers, and I won't go into all the scientific stuff behind them, but the one that you have to remember is, that's the active ingredient is the MGO. That's methyl glyoxal. That's the one active ingredient in Manuka honey. We have the largest selection of Manuka honey in the U.S. at the moment. It's independently tested. And you don't have to tell me about my honey. You can just ask the independent lab, and they'll tell you everything about it. And we carry the biggest range because there's so many people that just want to use Manuka honey. They don't have a problem. They don't want to pay $80, $60, $120 for a one-pound jar of honey. So we make a whole range that starts around $19 for a one-pound jar. They're just an everyday Manuka honey for those people that want to just add to their good health. And then we have them all the way up to the $120 level for those people that have specific conditions that they're trying to address. And this is where I really get irritated with some of these other companies, because people go and buy their product and it doesn't have the activity and it doesn't address the consumer's problem. And we get calls all day long, every day for the last 5 years, people buying honey and saying it didn't work. What's the problem? Hmm. So how is real Manuka honey real Manuka? By the lab test. You can't tell by looking. You can't tell by tasting. You can't tell by the consistency. We just grade it by the activity. That's all we do. So what it says on our label is what's in the jar.
So how can a consumer know that they're getting real Manuka honey when they're standing at the shelf and looking at different brands that are on the shelf? Is there something that's written on the label? Like, what should we be looking for?
There's two markers that are important to look for, and that's one, the MGO level. The MGO level should be over 30 for everyday Manuka honey, and it should be over 60 to start to get to be in a medicinal area. A lot of the ones you see on the shelf today, they'll put an MGO label on it, but it's 30 or lower. And they're really a multiflora Manuka. They're not a mono Manuka. Mono meaning single instead of multi-flavor, which is a lot of honeys blended together with the Manuka. A lot of people still do that today, put that on their label. But the MGO is the rating to look for. And there is an exclusive club called UMF, which we're not part of. But you do pay more for their trademark. And generally speaking, that's a good mark to look for, UMF. But the bottom line is if you are looking for an active Manuka honey to suit your purposes, say you have digestive issues, say you have immune compromised issues, say you're trying to do things for your skin, those kind of things, MRSA, all those kind of things where you need a high activity honey, the best thing to do is do your research and then ask the company if they have an independent lab test for that Manuka honey. Because if they don't, it's just talk. It's just numbers on a label. And that's why we do it for every jar that we import from New Zealand, to make sure that the consumer is getting exact. I mean, if we were just selling honey, I wouldn't worry about it. All honeys taste great. They're sweet. They're good for you. They do help your digestive tract. But when people are buying Manuka honey, they're buying it for its activity to treat certain problems that they're having. And so that's what we try to address, to make sure that they're getting exactly what they need. And that costs us a lot of money. Testing is not cheap.
Oh, I know. I've heard. So what type of Manuka honey products do you sell, and how can people use them?
We sell, again, the full range from a Manuka blend, which is our lower end and probably one of our biggest sellers, because most of the population don't have problems. They don't have to have a really strong one. I try to talk people down all the time. I say, you don't need to spend $80. I mean, I'm happy to sell those to you if you want them. But most people can just get away with a blend, or even what we call our 5+, which has an MGO rating of around 60. Mm-hmm. And you just take that once a day, one teaspoon a day on an empty stomach. And that's good for your everyday immune building and good healthy lifestyle.
And they come in jars, or do they come in sticks as well?
Yeah, come in 1-pound jars. We try to sell them in that. Some people sell smaller jars. It's just to make money, because it doesn't cost that much more to put it in a big jar or a small jar. The honey's about the same when you start to look at the pennies per pound price on it. So we sell those for the everyday public that just want to be healthy.
Well said. Thank you. I have one last question for you really quickly. How do you, David Knoll, spark change?
I spark change by selling the greatest products that come out of New Zealand to keep people healthy. I have as you read my bio, I have a lot of health concerns that have happened to me over the years, and I make sure that I can promote healthy products to keep people healthy. And that changes lives and brings a new spark to everybody's life every day. And the testimonials that I get over the last 30 years have just made my life worth living.
Thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome. Thanks, Andrea.